My focus is on the slogan. And Gina Amini, is, this is her image for those who have not seen her yet. So the slogan of the feminist revolution, Jin Jiyan Azadi in Kurdish, Women, Life, Freedom, in English, has really captured the imagination of the world orally, orally, textually, visually, and it has appeared in signs, placards, banners, images, and songs in many languages, in many different places, from streets to sit-ins, strikes, from celebration of freedom to battlefield cemeteries, as protesters lament the new wound and cry out that the names of the fallen heroes in these endless landscapes of remembrances to topple the Islamic Republic. The slogan is simple, it is rhythmic, and yet profound. It resounds, resonates throughout the world. It is unprecedented, but it has to be sought where its precedence exists. In the Kurdish movement, it had first been used by members of the Kurdish women's movement, founded on grassroots activism in response to persecutions from governments of Iran, Iraq, Turkey, and Syria. It was publicly used in Turkey in 2006 by Kurdish women to protest Turkish repression. It was again used in Western Kurdistan or Rojava, where in 2014, women fought and defeated ISIS. However, when the 20-year-old Gina, a Kurdish woman, was brutally murdered by the morality police of the Islamic regime, when during the funeral crowds in some town, Saqqiya's her hometown, in the cemetery chanted Jin Jiyan Azadi, several women cut their hair, their slogan, acts of protest spread throughout Iran and then the world like a wildfire. Women in diaspora followed suit, and in solidarity, men also joined the struggle against the Islamic Republic. Kurdish women had taken to the streets in the very inception of the Islamic Republic. Along with men, they had said no to the regime and participated in the Kurdish autonomy movement. Like other women, progressive women in Iran, they said no to the gender apartheid, national oppression, economic subjugation. They rose like blacks in this country, like women in the Me movement in this country. Gina became a rallying cry for gender equality, life, and freedom throughout the world. For the first time, all these frustrations and fury intersected with women throughout Iran, unifying nationalities, students, young men and women against the totality of one of the most oppressive regimes in the world. Now, under the power of this revolution, the Islamic regime is desperate. It is isolated. The entire region of Kurdistan, however, is under siege. The Islamic Republic has used the ideology of the center against the Kurds. It is regrettable that the Kurdish women and men have to continue to struggle under the gaze of chauvinism of the center, both that of the government and the opposition. Kurdish women, like other progressive women in Iran, are not interested in a fancy victory or a malicious and malignant disguise of a dress code or how their struggle shines through the corporate media for a day or two, and then the corporate world and media shatter or commercialize the image. I hope you give your full solidarity to the struggle and resistance of women everywhere. Women, including Kurdish women's struggle, is your struggle too. It is a transnational revolution against any form of marginalization and erasure. It is indeed, in short, against multi-layered oppression. As a famous Kurdish poet, Shurko Berkas, has said, "Now Egil is my homeland. Here she comes, O lovers, here she comes herself in the fall leaves clothed, with 19 yellow years, with 19 dark lights, with 19 green chalices, with the homesick autumn butterfly, she is on the way. She is coming to you, O lovers, she herself comes, this beloved, with the land and burned flower of the land she has picked. Here she comes. With her she brings the remembrance of a victim here. Here she comes, O lovers.